agora. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. These cars are much faster. Yeah, witness the speed we're seeing here. The pace is unbelievable. Baltimore burning away at first place. Second, Kubota Lars in the ambulance now having a look on the outside. Turbulence on the outside. Recooks it. Overcooks it. The ambulance now. There's the fighting throw down. And the McLean still out in front. Kubota now chasing them down. Oh, it is a crazy tight battle right now. Oh, my God.
Way through turn two.
Hey, really fast. Really going on. The rest of the field's a mad high. place where we're right to stick. McCaffrey, very good trip. I'm surprised by this. Very surprised by it. I don't know if the driver is currently used to the pace in that car, but it is way lower than ours. It should be so fast. Catastrophe is usually a car that's built on momentum. If you lose that momentum, you're not going to get good lap times. Like one or two laps get up the pace. It's something that Phantom always had above it. But at the same time, Phantom would lose a lot of momentum too because of that speed race. But that car is not here right now.
Well,
I thought it was going to be Catastrophe's day, but Baltimore Brothers is keeping it together. Lightning McQueen was 7 laps to go with Peter still. And the tremendous lead, I might add. Oh no, the Mario Kart lost its battery pack. Oh no, the battery's totally stuck on there. Currently, that car is in 12th place and dropped the quick. I see the choice going to pick up the 13 right now. Meanwhile, Patrick, second and third, that Ramulus driving through system records. I believe that. Caution. I3 just rolled it. Get it yet. Oh man, once a year, I3 rolls. Back on the way here. Slow your roll, I3. This battle for second and third is amazing. Ramulus versus R.D. Greasy. It is my favorite so far. And R.D. Greasy's on the outside. I don't know. You might like that fight. I'm not sure. That's up to the Grimm to decide. I don't know. Like the racing.
It is a delayed incident.
4 laps to go. 4 laps to go.
I think Ramulus has an answer for that.
Ramulus has an inside answer. The Grimm was right there to issue a penalty.
Now they're all
tied up. They're going to get a dirty look. Dirty look.
Greasy into the ambulance.
So many times and I missed them all.
The death there.
I can't see myself. And they collected four. Back underway. Oh, the penalty. The penalty for the ambulance.
Oh, no.
I have a feeling there's going to be an argument about that. That race incident, the third place. I can already hear the discussion that's going to be yelled at my ear after this race, yep.
Yeah.
But that's the Grimm, that's not my problem, that's the Grimm's problem. Are you greasy? Looking better, are you greasy now? Solid second place. Grimm has been going third. I don't know what he's having to do there. But Cartastrophe now moves up to third. Alright, this time by is the white flag for Baltimore. White flag situation here. Baltimore Burners doing a great job with Lightning McQueen.
Oh man, it's a really good
race. White flag for Baltimore Burners. All they have to do is keep together for this lap pass, but they're way ahead of everyone else.
Way ahead.
What an incredible run. I just won. One heck of a race right there, Lightning McQueen, Baltimore Burners, Patrick. That is going to be their first win, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, Baltimore Burners, the winner. Lightning McQueen, his first win. Baltimore Burners, first win ever. Second and third place go to R.U. Gracie and Catastrophe. Because of Catastrophe in front of them, probably back to third place. The Ramulus, after that penalty, fell all the way back to 10th. That, I'm sure, well, that's up to the Grimm to decide, I suppose. That is going to be very controversial, I imagine. The drama here is already palatable. And that will only get more palatable in an hour. At 4:30, it's been Lightning McQueen, R.U. Greasy, and Catastrophe in the center there. Lightning McQueen and R.U. Greasy enter.